glad to see you today. I hope you've had a really great week. So, I've got some jokes for you. I've been really practicing on my funny jokes. Okay, so here goes the first one. What did one microwave say to the other microwave? Is it really hot in here, or is it just me? Okay, wait, I've got another one. How many animals, this is a tricky one, did Moses take onto the ark? None! It was Noah, it wasn't Moses! Got you on that one. Okay.
Do you lose your items? Do you lose your things? Can you guess what these items are? Be careful, the pictures are really close up.
Sin, I got his guarantee. If God proved it all when Jesus rose again, God must be great, really great. So then be sure to trust him.
When the going gets tough, yeah, we can trust him. God is able enough to keep us standing, whatever may come our way.
Story, we're going to hear about a man who was lost and needed to be found. Now, do you remember last week's lesson? I'm going to ask you some questions to see if you remember last week. Number one, why was the lady so sad? Number two, what did Jesus do to bring the young man back to life? And number three, how did Jesus do this miracle? Think about those and see if you can find the answers. So, our secret agent is on the case of Jesus. Let's see what he's got going to investigate today.
Oh, look, he's drawing. It's our secret agent, isn't it, Bill?
There he is. That's what we're doing this week. We're secret agents.
Yeah.
He's just like us.
Uncovering the truth, sleeping, eating, donuts, football.
No, he's not like us like that. He's in the Bible, finding out what really happened, looking at the facts.
Yeah, he figures things out, doesn't he, Bill?
Yes, that's how he's like us. That's what we're doing this week.
I'm really enjoying it.
I know.
What's he doing now, then?
He's thinking again.
Thinking? But what about?
He's thinking about what we're looking at today.
Oh.
Which is Jenga towers.
Jenga towers?
Lego?
No. That's not Lego, it's a box, a gift.
Oh, I see. Is Jesus our friend?
Is he on our side with love and with care?
Or is he?
A candle?
Football?
A football on fire?
No, it's a bomb.
A bomb? Who gives someone a bomb?
Well, your enemy gives you a bomb. It's because if Jesus sees what we're really like, maybe he wants us out of his world.
Oh.
I'd understand if that's how he felt.
But it's still frightening, Bill.
It is. Jesus may be powerful.
So is Jesus our friend or our enemy?
That's what we're doing today. Let's go.
Yeah.
The secret agent has found out that Jesus is powerful. Now he wants to know, is Jesus our friend or our enemy? What do you think? Today's Bible story is from the book of Luke. Watch carefully to see if you can spot three things now. Number one, what did Zacchaeus do to see Jesus? Give you a clue on the story, it might be about Zacchaeus. Number two, why were the people upset that Jesus wanted to go to Zacchaeus's house? And number three, who did Jesus come to save?
Stories of the Bible, Zacchaeus. This is Zacchaeus.
Hey there!
Who was a tax collector and very rich. Tax collectors were hated because many people thought they were liars and cheaters.
Boo!
Zacchaeus lived in Jericho, and one day, Jesus was passing through Jericho.
What's going on?
Jesus is here! Woohoo!
Zacchaeus wanted to see who Jesus was.
Hey, excuse me.
Hey, watch where you're going.
But he was too short to see above the crowd.
Oh, that's it.
So he ran ahead to a place where he knew Jesus would come. He climbed to a sycamore tree so he could see Jesus. When Jesus came to that place, he looked up and saw Zacchaeus in the tree.
Oh, hey there, friend. Who, me? Yeah, you.
He said to him, Zacchaeus, hurry and come down. I must stay at your house today.
Oh, all right.
Zacchaeus came down quickly. He was pleased to have Jesus in his house. All the people saw this and began to complain.
Ugh.
Look at the kind of man Jesus stays with. Zacchaeus is a sinner. But Zacchaeus said to Jesus, I will give half my money to the poor. If I have cheated anyone, I will pay that person back four times more. Jesus said, salvation has come to this house today.
What?
This man truly belongs to the family of Abraham. The Son of Man came to find lost people and save them.
Hello everyone. Welcome back for week 3's craft. So you get your little bag. And then check what is inside. You have a can of Pringles, yummy. You will have some paper, colored paper. And you will have a little picture of Zacchaeus. What you will also need is some coloring in pencils and crayons. Some sticky tape and some scissors. So let's get started. First thing we're gonna do is eat some Pringles. Mmm. That's very yummy. Make sure to share with your family. Oh, yum. Those were so good, especially sharing them with my family. We finished it all in 10 minutes. But now what you're going to do is you're going to put your lid back on, and this Pringle can is going to be used as your treat trunk. So the first thing you're going to do is cut some pieces of sticky tape, just maybe 3, and stick them on the edge of your table. So what you're going to do is you're going to take this orangey yellow piece of paper and put it around your Pringle can and wrap it, and wrap it around the Pringle can really tightly. Whoopsie. If you're struggling, get someone to help you. And get some sticky tape and tape it. Now we're just going to stick the last piece of sticky tape on. And now our tree trunk is ready. Now we are going to make leaves for the tree. Get your 2 green pieces of paper. You can either tear them into long strips or smaller strips, tear them into pieces, or cut them into leaf-like shapes. What I'm going to do is tear them into strips. Now that you have made your leaves, glue or sellotape them onto your tree trunk in any way that you would like. This is what I have done. Well, this made a huge mess. We better clean it up. This is so much better. Now you're going to take your 2nd piece of orangey yellow paper and ask your parents to help you cut it lengthwise around this much. With that now being done, what we're going to do is we're going to colour in Zacchaeus. Now that Zacchaeus is all coloured in, let's just trim it on the sides just so he can fit onto the little tree. Now it's all trimmed. Now let's do the next step. Make sure you have a piece of sellotape on your table. Now you're going to wrap around this little strip around your tree, not too tight because it needs to be able to slide up and down. Now you're going to get your piece of sellotape and sticky tape it down. Now you can slide up and down. Now the last step is to glue Zacchaeus onto the moving part of the tree. Now he is all stuck on, and that's how Zacchaeus climbed the tree to get to Jesus. Climbed up and down to get to Jesus. Hope you had fun with this craft, and I'll see you next week for week 4. Bye!
Up.
Oh, here he goes, he's drawing.
Oh, it's that big hand, Bill.
Giant fingers.
Imagine if that hand poked you in the eye. Oh.
That would hurt, but it is Jesus' hand, and I don't think he does that sort of thing.
Loving that hand.
Oh, look, it's us, it's a secret agent, uncovering the truth, finding out what really happened.
Like a big mole, burrowing into facts to find the muddy truth.
No, I don't think that's right. More like a giant grabber coming down to reach hold of eyewitness truth from Luke's gospel.
Oh, what's the secret agent holding? Looks like he's got something in his hand.
Oh, well, let's see what it is. It's going to be a card or a banner. I love Jesus. Thank you very much.
It doesn't look like a card.
No, it doesn't. It's a machine gun.
A machine gun?
Why is he holding a machine gun?
That's not very nice. He must be a double agent or something.
No, he's just like us. The truth is we're pushing Jesus away. That's sin.
Loving that box. Jesus is so kind and generous. We're horrible to him, and yet he still holds out a lovely big gift.
Jesus is so kind. What love.
But whose side is Jesus on, Bill?
Well, we're like Zacchaeus, a long way from him.
And yet Jesus still came to save the lost.
Great!
Oh, yeah.
The secret agent has uncovered some truth about Jesus. He's discovered that Jesus came to save us. He came to save the lost. He came to save us. How cool is that? Have you ever been lost? One moment you're all safe and happy, and the next you have no idea where you are. What would you do if you were lost? Would you shout, "Oh!" or run really fast? How would you feel if you were lost and couldn't do anything about it? Today's story was about someone who was lost. He wasn't lost in the dark. He wasn't lost in a crowd or a strange place. He was lost from God. Today we found out what that means and how someone can be found with Jesus. We just heard a Bible story about Zacchaeus. Let's call him Zac. He was a really bad guy. He took money and he got rich by taking people's taxes. That's like taking extra money from people. Everyone knew that he did this. If you saw him walking down the street, people would cross the road to avoid him. If he came knocking on your door, people used to hide and pretend they weren't home. So when Jesus said he wanted to go to Zacchaeus' house, the crowd was not happy. No one in the town wanted to stay at Zacchaeus' house. Now, why would Jesus want to stay at Zacchaeus' house? Maybe he didn't know who Zac was. But when Jesus stopped under the tree, he looked up and he called, "Zac! Zacchaeus!" he said. "Hurry down, Zacchaeus. I must stay at your house today." Jesus chose to spend time with a bad guy. He went into the bad guy's house. He ate food with him. And he was a friend to the man. And all the people saw him and complained. They said, "Look at all the kind people. Look at who Jesus chooses to spend time with. Zacchaeus is a sinner." People knew Zac was a bad guy. He worked for the enemy and he took people's money. He was a sinner. He ignored God and he lived by his own way. People like Zac didn't deserve to be friends with Jesus. He wasn't good enough. He should have been in trouble for what he did. Not have Jesus staying at his house. But Jesus still chose to be friends with him, to stay at his house that day. And Jesus tells us why he did that. Because he came to find the lost, the people who didn't know him. That day, Zacchaeus went from being lost to being found. He went from being the enemy of God to a friend of God. And that day, Zacchaeus' life changed. He said, "I will give half of my money to the poor. If I have cheated anyone, I will pay that person back four times over." And meeting Jesus Zacchaeus went from being greedy to being generous. He promised to give back the extra money he had taken to the poor. Zacchaeus was a changed man, not just on the outside, but on the inside too, which is why Jesus said, "Salvation has come to this house today." Jesus was saying that Zacchaeus had been saved. Saved from his heart of sin. Like the man with the paralyzed legs, Zacchaeus' sins had been forgiven. The people in the crowd were upset because they thought they were better than Zacchaeus. They thought they were kind people and that Jesus should be friends with them. But the truth is that we are all sinners. They may have looked like they were better than Zacchaeus, but they also had a sin problem. We all do. We are all lost and we all need to be found and saved by Jesus. So it's great news that Jesus loves the lost. He loves me and he loves you. He doesn't love us for what we've done, but he wants us in his family. He wants to come to our home. He won't push us away because we aren't good enough. He looks for us if we are lost, whether we are good enough or not. And when Jesus finds you, he changes you. He changes you from an enemy to a friend of God. Earlier, we thought about what it feels like to be lost. And now imagine the moment that you are found. What joy, what a relief. Someone went looking for you because they loved you so much. How would you feel about the person who found you? Would you be thankful? Thankful that they've come looking for you, and thankful that they didn't give up on you, and that they can take you back home. When you've been found, you are safe. And if you're a Christian, then you are safe, safe in God's family. You used to be lost, and now you are found, forgiven, saved, and in God's family. Maybe you think that you don't need to be in God's family because you're a really good person. Remember the crowd. Don't just stand there and watch as Jesus finds other people. Or maybe you think that you can't be in God's family because you're too bad. Remember Zacchaeus. No one was too bad for Jesus to save them. Let Jesus find you. Let him forgive your sins. And let him take us home to be in Jesus' family. So, the big question of the day. Who did Jesus come to save? He came to save us. What a wonderful thing. Let's pray. And then I hope you have a really great week. And we'll see you next week. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for coming to save us. We thank you that even when we are lost, even when we do bad things, even when we have sin in our hearts, that you care about us so much, you come and save us. You take us out of the pit of sin and into your arms where it is safe and loved. We feel loved by you, Jesus. We thank you and we love you back. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.